Hey there, here's Arthur, and this video aims to give you a basic introduction into SciFlow. SciFlow is a browser-based online text editor designed to simplify the academic writing process for both people looking to write a paper on their own or in a team. SciFlow does that by automatically formatting your text via customized templates. Since we have the power of visual illustration at hand, you don't solely have to take my word for it, but rather can see how that looks in action. Take this document here I prepared, for example. It has some cover page information, a few chapters implemented, as well as some figures, some tables, some precious footnotes, and even some citations. Now here in the export menu, I pre-selected a thesis template. So when I click on download, I am presented with a fully typesetted PDF, including an automated table of content and even listings. If we jump into a chapter, we'll see that the chapters, as well as the figures and the tables, even the footnotes, are numbered on their own. And the big payoff, I don't even have to manually cite. That is all done for me in the matter of a single click. Of course, there are only so many theses one writes in their lifetime. So let's see what the spiel would look like for a different template. Back in the export menu, I now search for something different. A generic journal template seems fitting for the example. Let me also get rid of the cover page since journal papers generally don't need those. So with the old cover page gone and the new template properly selected, I'll download again. And this time I receive a Word file. When we look into this Word file, we'll see it has line numbering, as well as double spacing. Content-wise, nothing big has changed. When we get to the figures and the tables, or we scroll even further down, way down to the citations, we see that everything's still there. But format-wise, it obviously has adapted to a new use case, and that is how, by using SciFlow's templates, you can arrive at the needed formatting with a mere click. So in order to give you all the necessary information and tools on how to get to that point yourself and how to benefit from SciFlow when working as a team, this video in general focuses on three main steps. First, how to get things rolling by starting a new document. This step includes the proper use of templates and the creation of a suited chapter structure. Second, how to start writing. This step entails the creation of your written text as well as other text elements like figures, tables, and equations. Additionally, this step also includes cross-referencing and citing. And the last step is about starting to collaborate and covers how to invite others to your documents, how to manage their roles, and eventually how to use comments and other review tools. And since this video is conceptualized as a playlist, check the list for any topics that may interest you more than the others. And if you're here for the whole ride, we see each other at the next step, which is about templates.